Greetings. In part one of this series, I brushed up against the end of the times of the Gentiles. This next video will address a more political issue, which may not be of interest to all around the world. The end of America. It is coming at a pace which is unimaginable. Within the past 2 weeks, the oligarchs of SCOTUS have abandoned the Constitution. This only really matters to American citizens who can read, think, and who respect our national history. Those who have grown up with actual freedom, liberty, security, and independence. In the first issue, the Supreme Court created new law. In clear violation of the separation of powers established by the Constitution. The case involved federal funds illegally distributed under Obamacare. The law said such redistribution of wealth could only occur in states which had health care exchanges. SCOTUS said, "Damn the law. Give money regardless of what the law says." The few justices who still regard law essentially wrote, "Words now have no meaning." But laws are written in words, and words must have meaning. Ultimately, the liberal concept, "there are no absolutes," has borne fruit. If there are no absolutes, then words cannot have any absolute or certain meaning. America is no longer a country ruled by law. In the second issue, the Supreme Court created new religion. The institution of marriage is established by religion. SCOTUS has now imposed itself to define the definition of doctrines established in religious practice. This is the first step toward a national religion, partly or largely based on Sharia. Great Britain is evaluating a new law which will criminalize Christians. Under the guise of anti-extremism, saying Jesus is the Son of God may be a punishable criminal offense. America could quickly follow as the PC terrorists seek to silence the truth. America no longer has freedom of religion. In the third issue, the Supreme Court created new citizens. The act of voting is a right reserved for citizens of a country. But there are 15 million illegal aliens, criminals, in this country. Their opinion does not matter. Any more than Stalin, Putin, Hitler, the Shah of Iran, or Mao Zedong. And states, attempting to secure the voting process, have passed laws to stop fraud. Such laws, which protect the nation, should be respected by those who value the homeland. Not so the majority decision of SCOTUS. They abolished the laws that secure our democracy. Any foreigner may now vote without significant barriers. America as a nation of citizens has now been abolished in all real meaning. Further, the treason does not stop with passive negligence. The Obama regime has refused to enforce immigration laws, a clear violation of the oaths of office of the President and the Department of Justice. And not one Republican has asserted congressional oversight responsibilities. America is no longer a nation ruled by law. But are liberals through yet destroying America? Not yet. Not hardly. At this point, the Obama regime is still planting time bombs. Literally, they are giving Iran a clear path to a nuclear bomb. Snapback is smoking crack. I actually expect liberals will politicize the recent murderous shootings to lead to a liberal lawsuit to ban guns. One that will go directly or quickly to SCOTUS. Where SCOTUS will damn historical evidence and rule only the army may own any firearms. Tacit abolition of the Second Amendment by fiat of SCOTUS equates to abolition of the Constitution, the dissolution of America. That may just lead to the violent reaction the left wants to elicit, incite, create, cause. Remember, the motto of the communists is, let no crisis go to waste. And if you don't have a crisis to use, make one. Your hope is not in America. America was useful while it gave freedom to spread the gospel. But that time is past, and America is collapsing faster than the British Empire. You need to keep your trust in God and the message of the prophets. Villains got a vil, and Islam's got a kill. The beheading of Christians will resume after the Ramadan food orgy, which this year, 2015, is Wednesday, June 17th through Friday, July 17th. Coincidentally, that is 2 days after Jade Helm 2015 begins. And how exactly does Jade Helm 2015 play into the end of America? Well, as much fear-mongering and conspiracy crap as it has caused, you should think about the following. When the terrorist attack occurred at Fort Hood, the soldiers were sitting ducks. Because soldiers are not allowed to have armed weapons in their possession. Various sources, which I cannot confirm, claim Jade Helm is a live fire exercise. That should give any rational thinking citizen a moment of pause. The U.S. military is dispersing within America, fully armed and training to control and, if necessary, kill American citizens. Enjoy the show. This may be nothing, or it could get very real, very fast. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.